Kansas City Farmers, and I'm Farmer Bill.
And I'm Sam.
And we're talking about soil.
There's a whole bunch of different ways of growing your garden and what kind of, I guess you can call them vessels, of what you're going to be planting in, whether it be from in the ground, raised beds, or containers. But what do you fill them with?
And starting out with in the ground, a lot of times when you go to a nursery and you say you're going to put a garden in, they recommend compost or planting mix or something like that. Not a good thing to follow. When you want to know what to fix your ground with, you need to get a sample of the soil and test it. You need to find out how much organic material is in it, how much clay, sand, what the pH is, and also if there's a nutrient lacking in the soil. First of all, the one thing to know is that if weeds are growing in the garden area, then plants will grow.
That's interesting. I've never heard that.
Well, if it's contaminated soil, nothing's growing in it, you got another problem. Yep. You know, but that true is if weeds or if anything's growing there, you should have a successful garden.
Nice. Okay, so say if we're starting with a raised bed, and we've already talked about using a good topsoil in there. So after that first year of planting, what would they need to add to that?
Okay, so your topsoil you're gonna use should be 30% organic material minimum, maximum 40%, but also you need a mixture of sand and soil. The three together make a really good soil. You also need something for the plants to live on, fertilizer, okay? So how to figure that out? You take the length and width of your raised bed and the depth, and you multiply it out, and that will give you your cubic footage, in which case then if you divide 27 into your cubic footage, that will give you the quantity of cubic yards that you're going to need for your soil. In the bed in the ground, to figure out your soil minutes, you're going to need a length and width of the soil as well, along with a sample of the soil to know exactly what it needs. You can do the sample testing at home, or we do offer that service at the nursery just to help you get the proper nutrients and materials in the soil.
And I think that also helps with a lot of people, a lot of new gardeners. There's always kind of some hesitation on a lot of worry about it not working out. So having that proper foundation of soil to start with, you definitely do see a really good kind of outcome, a lot of less frustration. Then we're able to talk about fertilizing, which will be a whole nother video. After that season, it decreases. Why would your soil shrink?
The only things that are organic in soil is basically organic material, minerals, and fertilizer. Organic means that this stuff will break down to actually be plant food eventually, which causes your soil to shrink. What's not organic that stays there is the sand, the rock, the soil, the clay, and the loam. That all stays in the soil. So when you get a good base soil of that mixture, you're just going to need to amend it in order to bring it out back up to it. Do you amend it every planting? You might have to, or you might be able to do every other garden planting, but eventually you're going to need to add those things because those are the only things that will dissipate from the soil.
Yeah. A lot of times we see people go and they'll get a bag of potting soil and put it in their container, a raised bed. For a raised bed, you really don't want to do that because if you feel a bag of soil, it's really light. And a lot of that has to do with shipping. So what happens is you plant in it and it's all just organic matter, so it all shrinks down. So if you fill up your raised bed, pretty much probably in the middle of your growing season, you're gonna end up, if you start with a foot of soil, you end up with about half. So that's why going with the topsoil is always a good idea, unless you're gonna do container gardening.
Now, container gardening is a little bit different. You're working with a smaller container and you're planting more frequently, so a really good potting soil would be beneficial for it. How do you know if it's a really good potting soil? If it's really inexpensive, a lot of times it's not a great potting soil, but you also find out what people are using and find out if they have success with it. You know, we always figure, getting back to the quality of the soil is going to be how your plants grow and how well they grow by the good quality of the soil. So when you do plant in a container, always make sure that you're all the way up to the top, because with all that organic matter, it's going to shrink. And it's tough to get more soil into the container because you have to go on the bottom of the roots than it is on top. So you want to make sure that as it settles, you're not going to have a plant buried way down in the pot because the soil dissipated out of it. I hope that made soil for your garden simple. This is Farmer Bill.
And Sam. And if you do have any other questions, come and talk to us. Also bring in that soil sample. We'll definitely be able to help you out and get you on the right path. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe so you can learn more about everything you know about urban homesteading.
And please come into the nursery and bring a soil sample, if you will. And we'll help you get started on having a fantastic garden, no matter what container you grow in.